Hey everyone, I wanted to show some projects I've been working on to make entering text on a Flipper Zero easier. I'll start with some demos, and then I'll show how to upgrade your Flipper Zero firmware. In a future video, we'll take a look at some of the key sections of the code. Let's get started. The first demos use an Xbox 360 Chatpad. You can find one of these on eBay for about $15 US. For this first demo, we'll go into apps and then scripts, and then we'll go to the chatpad.js script. This script doesn't need any special firmware. There's no firmware modifications required. And when you press a button on the chatpad, you can see that the JavaScript is able to show the letter that was pressed. This next demo does use custom firmware. Go into settings, and the custom firmware adds a new chatpad setting. In config, I'll turn the chatpad to on, and then I will edit the macro for D, and I'll type in my name. And we can actually use the chatpad to type in the text. So we'll do Mr. Derek Jameson. And you can see how using the chatpad is a lot faster than having to input using the D-pad. And then when we go back and then go into chatpad, you can see the chatpad is on and it says ready. And as I press letters on the chatpad, you'll see that it shows which character was pressed. If I hold down the people icon and press D, then you can see that macro. I'll also add a macro for the L key to do light instead of just L. And then I'll go into apps and then GPIO. And then in here, I have a FlipSocial. Depending on your firmware, FlipSocial may be in a different folder. And then under post, add pre-save. And this time I'll use that people D button to auto expand our macro. And you can see we can quickly enter FlipSocial messages. Next, we'll go into sub gigahertz and then read. And then I'll press a button on my remote control. And then we'll go ahead and click on save. And then you can just type in the name of the signal. So I'll go ahead and do bedroom light, and then I'll use that macro L for light. Sometimes if you type too quickly, it doesn't pick up the key. For this demo, I'll read another remote, and we'll go ahead and choose save. And then over on our mobile phone, we'll go to options, and then file manager, ext, and then we'll go into input-line.txt and say edit. And now we can use our phone keypad to type in our message. So now it just takes a couple seconds to name your signal as dining room light. So no more guessing what that d.sub file is. For the last demo, we'll capture one more signal. Go ahead and go to save. We'll open that input-line.txt file again and say edit.
Bedroom light.
And then we'll click the save button. So that's it for the demos that I have, but I'd love to collaborate with someone to add a keyboard option to the mobile app. For the next part of the video, I wanted to show how to take apart the chat pad. Again, you can find these on eBay for about $15. The first step is to remove these four T6 screws. And you can see that these are just little tiny screw heads with a T6 shape. Once you've done that, there's also these little things in the corner that are like these rubber sticky things. And I remove those as well. I'm not sure if you have to or not. And then I carefully pried it apart, and you can see these little clips that were holding things together. And there was also some clips on the other side. And once we got that apart, then there was these two pieces. And then next, I carefully removed the 7-pin connector. And then removed the 5 Phillips screws. One's in the center and the others are in the corners. And then carefully removed the keypad from the frame. And you'll see there's also little clips here that are holding it together. And then hopefully you'll have just the keypad. And be careful with it because it can also separate into multiple pieces. Next, I attached a 7-pin connector, and just be gentle with that, but make sure it's all the way down. My connector used red, white, blue, green. And then on my Wi-Fi module, the red went to 3.3, which is pin 9. The white went to IO8, which is pin 15. The blue went to IO7, which is pin 16. And the green went to ground, which is pin 18. If you don't want to solder a header, you can just connect the wires directly into the Flipper Zero GPIO pins. This project's made available on GitHub under the repository name Flipper Zero Input. If you scroll down, you'll see the steps for firmware installation. The first step is to make sure you've installed Git for your computer. I'll go ahead and download that for Windows. Go ahead and run the installer once it's downloaded. We'll just go ahead and click install. And then while it's installing in the background, I'll go ahead and show you the next steps in here. So we've installed the Git. So the next step is to decide which firmware we want to apply our changes to, official or Momentum. And there's also a version for Unleashed and for Roguemaster. Once it's done, go ahead and click finish. I'll just go ahead and close the release notes. And then in my case, I'll go ahead and do official. So go ahead and click the copy button. And then we're going to open a command prompt. So type CMD and then choose command prompt. And then I'll right click paste into the window. And this will run all of those commands for whatever firmware you've decided. Make sure your Flipper Zero is plugged in and that QFlipper is not running. I'll go ahead and set that window off to the side so we can see it. Switch back to our browser. Once the firmware is installed, you'll be able to use your phone's Bluetooth or a Chatpad to enter text in the text input fields. By default, we install dev instead of release or a tag like 112. If there's a particular version of the firmware you would like these changes applied to, then replace quote dev quote with quote in the version you want. To make the edits, you'll need to paste it into Notepad or something similar. Over in the command window, you can see some red text about things that were modified and untracked files. This is perfectly normal. This is the patch that we're applying to the firmware. Here are some notes that describe the above script. And then once your firmware is updated, you're going to want to do Bluetooth setup. I'll go ahead and click on the Flipper Zero mobile app. This is the mobile app from the Flipper Zero team. You can install it for the App Store or for Google Play. And then there's directions on how to pair your phone with your Flipper Zero. And once you've done that, just follow all of these steps here. As I improve the firmware patch, these steps may change, so I'm not going to walk through these steps. Just follow whatever the instructions say. Thanks for watching this video. Please like and subscribe. And if you have any problems, feel free to reach out to me on Discord or click the Issues link and leave a comment there.